Look, there's clearly a large need for a test with this breakthrough performance. This is a serious illness with millions of people waiting for a reliable diagnosis all around the globe. Now, we will look at the quickest way to make a commercial test available.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Bartu Ahiska from Oxford BioDynamics. Bartu, very good to speak with you. Wednesday's announcements outlined a breakthrough blood test for chronic fatigue syndrome. Can you summarize why this is so significant?
Absolutely, and thank you for having me. This has been an exciting week for us at Oxford BioDynamics, being able to share the news that this is the first time someone's been able to detect chronic fatigue with such high accuracy and from blood. It's a major milestone for us, and the breakthrough data should give hope for patients who are affected by what is a serious illness for millions of people worldwide.
Bartu, the tests show 96% accuracy. How does that compare to current diagnostic approach by AIMI chronic fatigue syndrome? And what does it mean for patients and clinicians?
Well, what it means, chronic fatigue can be life-shattering. I mean, it leaves people with extreme tiredness, unable to work or get on with their normal daily activities. And as a result, many of them are housebound or bedbound for years. And this disease really has been poorly understood and doesn't have a reliable single diagnostic currently, leaving many to be told that it's all in your head. Therefore, a test with the performance that our data shows would very well be a game changer with 96% accuracy, 92% sensitivity, and 98% specificity. But to put it into perspective, yes, it still needs to be taken through some next steps before it could be used. So it needs to go through a validation step, evidence of clinical utility, and set up operationally in a clinical lab environment.
How has OBD's EpiSwitch platform enabled this breakthrough?
Well, OBD, Oxford BioDynamics, has a we have the core EpiSwitch platform and knowledge base, out of which we have developed a number of practical tests, including two on the market today that are currently helping patients. But going back to our chronic fatigue work, this was developed using this same proven EpiSwitch platform. So to kind of explain briefly how that works, traditional genetic tests look at how at the fixed DNA code that you were born with. But we know that chronic fatigue is an illness that you're not born with. It develops. And that's one of the reasons why using EpiSwitch markers, which can change during a person's life, are key to achieving this level of breakthrough accuracy. At OBD, we looked at how DNA is folded and switched on or off in three dimensions inside the cells in our blood. And these folds change with chronic fatigue, whether someone has the condition or not. And that gave us a unique signature that appears time and time again in blood from patients with the illness.
With over 400,000 sufferers in the UK, what's the commercial potential of this test, Bartu, and how soon could it be available in clinical settings?
Look, there's clearly a large need for a test with this breakthrough performance. This is a serious illness with millions of people waiting for a reliable diagnosis all around the globe. Now, we will look at the quickest way to make a commercial test available. We have said that we will look to co-develop or license the test with a partner to bring it into either OBD's clinical labs or with our existing infrastructure or a partner facility.
And what kind of partners are you looking for?
So we anticipate strong interest from diagnostic or healthcare companies focused on complex diseases and precision medicine. The peer-reviewed results speak for themselves. There's also growing momentum within the NHS and other health systems internationally to improve diagnosis and care for CFS, for chronic fatigue syndrome, and related conditions. So we see opportunities across both the private and the public sectors.
What steps are needed before this test can be adopted clinically, and how long might that take?
So these published results are a real milestone, but moving it from there into clinical practice will require some more steps. So these include what I mentioned briefly, this extended analytical validation, demonstrating the clinical utility and operationally placing the test within our labs or our partners' labs. But what is important here is that we've successfully and rapidly navigated this whole process before. It's not new to us. And with our accurate prostate cancer detection test, the EpiSwitch PSC, we did it, and also our pan-cancer checkpoint immunotherapy response test, the EpiSwitch CERT test. So we're confident we can replicate this swiftly for CFS, perhaps as quickly as a year with the right support coming in.
Bartu, is this test protected by your existing IP portfolio, and how scalable is the technology for global rollout?
Absolutely, yes. The EpiSwitch platform, our markers on it, the disease-specific patterns that we see, these are all protected within our IP portfolio that we control. And we've made sure that the platform is inherently scalable. So it's already used here and across the US for our cancer programs. And that's why we believe we could move quickly to build access for a new CFS test by also using that know-how and linking with partner labs worldwide.
I mean, can the test also be used to diagnose those with post-COVID syndrome, also known as long COVID?
Good question. We know that chronic fatigue and long COVID share some overlapping biological pathways and symptoms. What we've established here, together with the University of East Anglia, we believe provides a strong foundation for developing a similar test for long COVID, yes. And as you know, that is also a serious global issue. It seems to affect, I believe, 6 in every 100 people who've had COVID-19.
Bartu, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress with that. Thank you very much for taking the time today.
Thank you. Like I've said, it's an exciting moment for us at OBD, and more importantly, hopefully exciting for patients who've been waiting too long for a breakthrough.
Well, Bartu, great speaking with you. Bartu Ahiska from Oxford BioDynamics.